if two charges q1 and q2, q1 be a charge here and q2 be a charge here, they are separated by a distance r, then Coulomb force acting between these two charges F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 into q2 by r square, as we all know. But this result we will achieve using Gauss theorem. From Gauss theorem we know that phi is equal to q1 by epsilon naught. If we draw a sphere here of radius r and taking q1 at the center, of course the surface of the sphere will pass through q2. Because q1 and q2 are at a distance r, q1 is center, and if r radius is taken, then if a sphere is drawn, that sphere will pass through charge q2. And as we learned, if this is the sphere, the total number of electric flux that will come out of the sphere will be equal to q1 by epsilon naught, because inside the sphere there is only one charge. So that charge divided by epsilon naught will be the net flux that will come out of this sphere. And net flux is also, we know that E delta is cos theta. What is cos theta? Cos theta is the direction, angle between the direction of electric field and area. So if we consider any area, be it here, be it here, be it here, or be it here, every point will have the direction of E is outward normal, and direction of area is also outward normal, and both the directions are identical. So every time, everywhere, if you take E and del S, they will have the same area, same direction, and angle between E and del S will be zero. So for cos theta we can write cos 0 degree. At every point E magnitude of field is constant, because every point we, if you take on the surface of this sphere, this distance is going to be r. And your electric field, you know that electric field is equal to charge divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. Your electric field is equal to charge divided by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. So charge is constant, that is q1, 4 pi epsilon naught constant, and separation, that is point at which I am required to find out the field, is r every time. So E will be constant, so E can be taken outside the integration sign. Cos 0, it has got a fixed value. So we can consider q1 by epsilon naught is equal to E being constant comes out of the integration sign. There is cos 0 degree. Cos 0 degree is 1. And this is the total surface area. That is the surface integral of this. That is going to be 4 pi r square. So your E becomes q by epsilon naught divided by 4 pi r square. If we rearrange it, it is going to be 4 pi epsilon naught r square. This is the electric field at this point. And if Q2 is now the test charge which is on the field having value this, the force, the value of force is equal to charge into electric field E. Because electric field E is the force acting on unit positive charge. And if here charge is Q2, then the force will be Q2 into electric field. For 1 Coulomb charge, the force is E. For 2 Coulomb charge, force is 2E. For 3 Coulomb charge, force is 3E. And for Q2 Coulomb charge, force will be Q2 into E. We learned in earlier video that E is the force that is active on 1 Coulomb charge. So at this point, the value of field is E. So force will be for 1 Coulomb charge E. For 2 coulomb charge, at this point, force will be 2E. For Q2 coulomb charge, force will be Q2 into E. And your force is equal to Q2. And what is the value of Q? E. It is Q1 from Gauss theorem of this. Q1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught R square. Now, this was from Coulomb's law. And this I have derived from Gauss theorem. So, from Gauss theorem, we can reach to Coulomb's law. And this is an important derivation. So, make it very clear and prepare it very carefully. So that if asked in examination, you can write well. That's what I mean.